God of our healing. He has it all. But Jesus says this in the book of John, that I am the way, the truth, and the life. That no one can get to the Father except through me. So it's the idea that Jesus is the center. Jesus reaches out his hand, touches his Father, reaches out his other hand, and touches his children. You see, when Jesus is in the center, when Jesus is in the middle, we can receive our healing. We can receive our forgiveness. It is through Jesus our salvation comes. So this morning, is it okay if we put Jesus where he rightfully belongs? In the center of our lives, in the center of our church, in the center of our hearts. Father God, Lord, you are the beginning and the end. We worship you, Lord, not because of what we have, Lord God, or what you give us, Lord, but because of simply who you are, Father. That it is you, Lord, you are the door, Father God, the doorway, the entrance, Lord, that we may enter and receive our healing from our Father. So, Lord, we put you in the center right now, Lord, of our worship. Let our focus and our minds and our hearts be open to you right now. Release the bondages of our hands that we may lift them up in worship to you. Because you are worthy of every praise that leaves our lips. So today, Lord, we ask you to be the center of it all. We worship you.
Jesus at the center of it all. Jesus at the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus.
Everything we want.
altar a new home. Jesus, be the center of new home. Every knee will bow, and every tongue shall confess you, Jesus.
Jesus, you are welcome here. Father, we pray that through this worship, Lord, you minister to our hearts. You mend the brokenness, Lord. You fill the voids. Father, God, we thank you for your Son, Lord. That it's through him, Lord, we can receive our healing. We can receive our protection, receive our provision. It is through your Son. Lord, we are forever thankful, Father, that even when we make mistakes, Father, even when we fall short, Lord, you are not a God to say, I told you so, but you are a God that says, I love you so. Lord, we ask, Lord, to be the center of this worship, be the center of this sermon, be the center of today, Lord God, for it is all about you, Father. Holy Spirit, we pray that you move in this place. We pray that you touch every seat, every heart that is in those chairs, Father God. We pray that you speak life, that you speak encouragement, Lord God. That you bring healing, Father God. We pray that you do a mighty work, Lord. Not just through the worship, Lord God, but through the sermon as well, Father. For we are a church of practical knowledge, Lord God, that we will live out your word, Father God. Father God, we pray that you increase, Lord, in our church, in our communities, Lord God, in our lives. Father, be the center of our homes, Lord. Because, Lord God, that's where the enemy wants to attack us most, Father God, is in the household, Lord, through the families and through the fathers, through the wives, Lord God, through the mothers, Lord God, through the husbands, Lord. Lord, we pray for your covering over everyone here, over our children, Lord God. And we pray and we lift up our missions team, Father God. But we know, Lord God, that they may have missed their flight, Lord. But we know, Lord, it's all a part of your plan, Father. We know, Lord, that you have a plan and a purpose for that, Lord. Whether there is still ministering to be done, Father God, or whether it's your hand protecting them, Lord God. Lord, but we just thank you in advance for every victory. We thank you in advance for every blessing. And we thank you, Lord God, just for who you are, Lord. Not for the shiny things or the good things, Lord, that you may give us, Lord, but just simply because of who you are, Father. Lord, you get all the glory at the end of the day, Lord God. We cannot do this without you. We cannot do church without you, Father God. So we need your presence. Fill this place. We pray that you anoint your speaker. Give him the fire and the words, Lord God, to administer, Lord God, your word, Lord. We pray, Lord, that you pour into him as he pours into us, Father. Let every word pierce the hearts of the believers, and let it fall on good soil, and let it may find deep roots. We thank you, we praise you, and we honor you. In Jesus' mighty and matchless name, we all say, amen.